a stranger to the dark. Hide away, they say, we don't want your broken parts. I've learned to be ashamed of all my scars. Run away, they say, no one will love you as you are. But I won't let them break me down to dust. I know that there's a place for us, for we are glorious. When the sharpest words wanna break me down, I'm gonna stand in blood, gonna drown them out. I am brave, I am bruised, I am who I'm meant to be. This is me. Look out, 'cause here I come.
Hi, champions. We're so glad you joined us today. Are you ready to do the declaration? All right, repeat after me. I am special and extraordinary. I am not average. I have been custom made. I am one of a kind. Of all things God created, what He is the most proud of is me. I am His masterpiece, His most prized possession. I will keep my head held high, knowing I'm a child of the Most High God, made in His very image. This is my declaration. Okay, champions, that was fantastic. Great job.
Hi, champions. In today's lesson, we're going to talk about sharing and how it brings us happiness. Do you know that when we share with others that it pleases God? And pleasing God makes us happy. Let's read the equation together. Ready? I have something to share, plus I share with others equals God is pleased and I am happy. Good job. You know that sharing also helps us make friends. I have my favorite toy here, and I want to share it with my friend Araceli. Hi, Araceli.
Hi, Norma.
Will you play with me?
Yes.
Awesome. I want to share my favorite toy with you because you are my friend.
Thank you, Norma.
Yay. When we are sharing with our friends, we must remember to use nice words. Thank you, Araceli, for playing with me.
Thank you for inviting me and sharing your toy.
Now, let's get ready to do our Bible declaration.
Hi, champions. It's time for our Bible declaration. Are you ready? Repeat after me. This is my Bible. I am what it says I am. I have what it says I have. I can do what it says I can do. Today, I will be taught the Word of God. I boldly confess. My mind is alert. My heart is receptive. I'll never be the same. I am about to receive the incorruptible, indestructible, ever-living seed of the Word of God. I will never be the same. Never, never, never. I will never be the same. In Jesus' name, amen. Well done, champions. Now, let's watch our Bible story.
Stories of the Bible. Jesus feeds the 5,000. This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love. He did many miracles and healed people of their sickness. A huge crowd kept following him wherever he went because they saw his miraculous signs as he healed the sick. A crowd started to gather around Jesus. There were 5,000 men and many more women and children. Turning to Philip, he asked,
"Hey, Philip!
Where can we buy bread to feed all these people?" You see, Jesus was testing Philip, for he already knew what he was going to do. Philip replied, "Even if we worked for months, we wouldn't have enough money to feed them."
Hey, I got an idea.
Then Andrew spoke up. "There's a young boy here with 5 barley loaves and 2 fish. But what good is that with this huge crowd?" Jesus said, "Tell everyone to sit down." Then Jesus took the loaves, gave thanks to God, and gave them to the people.
Here you go.
Afterward, he did the same with the fish, and they all ate as much as they wanted.
Want some more?
I'm all good, thanks.
After everyone was full, Jesus told his disciples, "Now gather the leftovers so that nothing is wasted."
You got it.
So they picked up the pieces and filled 12 baskets with scraps left by the people who had eaten from the 5 barley loaves and 2 fish.
Hi, champions. Welcome back. I hope you enjoyed the Bible story. Now, it's time for a vocabulary and scripture verse worksheet. We're going to learn 4 new words today. Our first word today is share. To share means to give part of what you have to others, like sharing your snack or a toy with your friend. Our second word is thoughts, and those are the things or ideas you think about that are in your head and you don't say out loud. Our third word is feelings. Feelings are your emotions, like happiness when you eat your favorite snack or sadness when you lose your favorite toy. And our last word is action. And that means what you do, like in our Bible story when the young boy shared his lunch with all the people. Now, I want you to help me with an activity. I'm going to show you some pictures and I want you to tell me if it's okay to share with friends or family or if it's not okay. Are you ready? Here we go. The first picture is an apple. This is a snack. Is it okay to share with friends? Everyone say yes, because it is okay to share snacks with our friends. Next, we have medicine. Is medicine okay to share with your friends or family? The answer is no. That could be very dangerous. What about a toothbrush? Is it okay to share your toothbrush? The answer is no again. It's not okay to share our toothbrushes. Good job. Next, we have a picture of a toy. This is something we can play with a friend, so it is okay to share. What about a computer? Is it okay to share with friends and family? The answer is yes. It is okay to share our toys and computer. Our last picture is the bathroom. The bathroom should not be shared unless you need help from your mom or dad or from anyone your mom and dad says it's okay. If you do not need help in the bathroom, then the bathroom should not be shared. You guys did a great job. Thank you for helping me with the activity. Now, let's get ready for the next activity.
Today we're reading God Created Everything by Pan Giorgio. God created the sun and the moon. He created water and the land. God created fish and the birds. He created land animals and people. God created everything. Wow, that was an awesome book. See you guys next time.
Hi, champions. Feelings are a special system designed by God that provides us with information about the world around us. Feelings come from our thoughts. What we think affects how we feel, and how we feel can control how we act. If you can control your thoughts, then you can control your actions. Today, we learned that sharing with others pleases God and it makes us happy. God wants us to share and be kind to one another. Today's memory verse can be found in Hebrews 13:16. Let's say it together. Share with others because it makes God happy. Great job! We'll see you next time.
We want to give you an opportunity to accept Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. You see, Jesus died upon the cross for your sins. He gave his life for you. And when you ask him into your heart, what that means is that he will live with you forever. Would you like to ask Jesus into your life today? Then pray this prayer with me. Dear Jesus, I ask you to forgive me of all my sins. Give me a new start in you. I give my life to you today. I love you, Jesus. Come into my heart. In Jesus' name, amen. Wow, I am so proud of you today that you made that decision to ask Jesus into your heart. Now, he will live in your heart forever, and one day you'll be in heaven with him. Isn't that cool? All of heaven's rejoicing with you. So proud of you, champions. Okay, champions, it's so important that we speak positive words over our life every day. These words are life to us. Are you ready? Here we go. I am equipped. I am amazing. I am well able. I am a masterpiece. I am brilliant. Great job.
Thank you so much for watching. See you next time.